The Stanford Start Home Project was Stanford's first ever entry into the U.S. Department of Energy's Solar Decathlon competition, which, for those of you who don't know, is a biannual competition hosted by the U.S. Department of Energy, in which they select 20 collegiate teams internationally to compete and build net zero solar homes. So this is actually a photograph from the 2011 competition, which was the competition that actually inspired Stanford to apply. The last competition took place this past October, just in Irvine, California, actually, so just a couple miles away if you're ever interested. And from the very start, we were kind of different from a lot of the other teams. To give you an idea of what it was like to work on this project, we had over 150 students, undergrad and graduate, come through the doors of the project. For many of us, it was the most incredible opportunity to really apply what we learned, you know, in our textbooks to the real world and actually constructing a home that can actually be lived in. When we were first approaching the project, we were kind of different. We didn't want to think about it in terms of just the two-year time frame of the project itself. We wanted to think about it on a much larger scale. So we thought about the housing industry, about technology, and what kind of an impact we as students could make. To start out with, we were actually really inspired by the car industry. So modern cars are ever and ever more efficient. Every year, they're held to higher and higher standards of affordability and sustainability. And we thought about, well, how did this happen, and why hasn't the housing industry ever seen anything similar? So we went back to the very first cars, to assembly line manufacturing. And it turns out that Henry Ford's first Model T actually wasn't really a complete car. It was actually built around a common chassis or frame. And what's interesting about this is that this really let customers at that time build their car around this frame. And we thought, why can't houses do the same thing? Maybe not a frame so much as more of an engine, something that can really power your home, which is exactly what we did with the core. So hopefully, if you've heard of the Start Home, you've heard of the core. And what it is we've taken the most complicated electrical, mechanical, and plumbing systems and put them in a single unit that can be mass manufactured. It can actually be spec'd to fit your needs in a factory, put on a standard flatbed truck, shipped directly to your site, where you can actually build whatever kind of a home you want around it. So you can do something more traditional, like an Eichler home, or you can do something more modern, which is exactly what we did for the Start Home. So this is actually an early rendering of the house. You can see the core as that silver box in the middle. It actually includes your mechanical room, your kitchen, your bathroom, and your laundry room. And this is a photograph of the house in Irvine. You can see we got pretty close to theory. It was really exciting. And to give you an idea of what it's like inside the home, this is a view from the living room, and this is the dining and kitchen and the outdoor space. And looking at these photographs, you kind of begin to think what it would be like to grow up in a home like this that's incredibly technologically advanced, which actually made us start to think about technology itself, its role in how we live, how we grow up, how we interact with each other and the world, and how we learn. In the age of Google Glass and iPhones, the digital world is at our fingertips, a world that has been tested, designed, and manufactured to be automated. But the thing is that life isn't about automation. It's not about effortlessness. It's really about agency. It's about taking control and accepting responsibility for your role in a larger narrative, whether that's the energy narrative or something broader like education or something else entirely. So we really wanted to bring the homeowner into the life cycle of the home instead of just, you know, designing out the user. We wanted people to really be aware of where their energy comes from and realize that energy is not limitless. It's finite, and it comes from a source, and it also has to go somewhere. To this point, the first thing we designed was just this kind of app, a way to check in on your home's performance. This is data taken from different sensors scattered throughout the house and really compiled on a really easy graphical interface. You can imagine that with this kind of data infrastructure, one day, energy affordability and sustainability actually becomes a social thing. So you can compare your performance with your neighbor, and if your neighbor uses more water than you do 1 week, they have to buy the next round at the bar. The other thing that we designed, or the other thing that we thought about, was how we interact with energy, from the way you turn on and off your faucets to the way you turn on and off your lights. Right now, lights, well, light switches are a very binary thing. They're either on or off, and it's really easy to just leave them on. So we really didn't use light switches in our house. We use these things called room switches. And what these are, it's actually a touch interface, just like your trackpad on your computer. And just with these simple finger gestures, you can actually control your lights, you can control your outlets, you control everything inside of your room that draws energy. And it kind of cues you into where this energy is coming from. And this idea of agency is perhaps the greatest thing that I took from the project, whether that's in the way that we build homes, in the way that we interact with each other and learn, or if it's just in the way that we live our lives. Thank you.